Hello and welcome to a new short tutorial. This tutorial is a cross-section of a 5-hour long tutorial that you can find in the description. We will start with the cabin. For start, I will create a basic shape, ground and set up the camera. After that, we can start adding details, mainly by adding loop cut Ctrl R, extrude E, extrude along normals Alt T, scale S and bevel Ctrl B. Tip: if you change from global to normal orientation, you can easily follow the angle of the roof. This option is often useful. To create a door, add a loop cuts on all sides, select the face and use I for insert and E for extrude. You can repeat this several times. Use key for the knife to create slanted planes. We can use doors as shutters. To rotate them correctly, move the origin to the right. To see more details while modeling the cabin, we can improve the lighting a bit before we creating the volumetric lighting at the end. For this purpose, I will darken the world, add an area lamp on the side to create shadows, and inside the cabin I will add orange lights. Now we can continue with details such as stairs and fans. I get the base material for the cabin by mixing two plain textures. I want to keep more of the white plain texture to make the cabin more visible in the night conditions, but I also use a brown plain texture to add more details. As a factor, I use brown wood texture, which I convert into black and white map with color ramp. Black has value of 0 and white has value of 1 in Blender. I also want to create the real geometry. I made several planks and spread them around the cabin. I made the variations with the UV map and added a lot of imperfections to give it realism. I also added graffiti and leaking texture to create poor details. For this I use images as plain add-on and I use the alpha value. If the image is not a PNG and has no alpha value, the white color connected into alpha has value of 1, which means completely transparent. Chimney was created procedurally to practice the procedural materials in the tutorial. I mix brick and noise texture. With the color ramp, you can add variations in the colors of the bricks. For the floor, I used texture from ambientcg.com as a base, and above I added photo scans I took in my neighborhood. You can download photo scans on my Patreon. I use car from transportation add-on and the trees from botanic add-on. In the tutorial I suggested several options where you can download quality car and trees assets for free. For final lighting I combine volumetric with a point lamp. You need to play with a strength and position to get realistic lighting. I use Mixamo to animate the human and Shakeify add-on to animate the camera. This is the result after rendering and this is after post-processing. You can find more about post-processing as well as how to create the other two animations and how to make transition and glitchy effect in After Effects in the link below. I created the atmosphere for these renders in a similar way.